The following teaching is possible thanks to the friends and partners of Spirit and Truth Fellowship International.
Throughout the Bible, there's good evidence that Jesus is not God. And in our discussions with our Trinitarian brothers, we need to go back to the text and see what the text says, because we're going to make the assertion that Jesus Christ is who he says he was and who the Bible says he was, the Son of God, not God. And there's evidence for this all through the Bible. And an interesting piece of evidence occurs in the four Gospels themselves, and is wrapped up in the record when Jesus's mother, Mary, and she had rounded up some relatives, or some relatives had rounded her up, and they went to take charge of Jesus because they said he was out of his mind. Now, let's take a look at the record. We're going to start in the Gospel of Luke. And here we are in Luke chapter 8, starting in verse 19. Now Jesus' mother and brothers, now the word brothers here could mean relatives, but my tendency is to think that it was his brothers. Now Jesus' mother and brothers came to see him, but they were not able to get near him because of the crowd. Jesus is in the house, he's talking with people, there's a huge crowd, they can't get in. Someone told him, "Your mother and your brothers are standing outside wanting to see you." He replied, "My mother and brothers are those who hear God's word and put it into practice." Whoa, that's a little uncharacteristic for Jesus, who is love, who thought of his family, who took care of his family. His mothers and brothers come to see him. Somebody says, "Hey, your mom and brothers are outside." And he says, "Let me tell you who my mom and brothers are." Wow, why would Jesus be so terse, so seemingly rude to his family in this situation? That seems so uncharacteristic. And to get the answer to that, we have to read the other Gospels. So we go to the Gospel of Mark, which has the answer to this. In Mark chapter 3, verse 20, Jesus entered a house, and again a crowd gathered, so he and his disciples were not even able to eat. I mean, this is how packed the place was and how busy they all were. Verse 21, when his family heard about this. Now, not just heard about him being in a house, but you have to go back in Mark, in the other Gospels, and find out that Jesus was casting out demons, he was healing the sick, and he'd rounded up 12 men, and he'd labeled them his apostles, he'd, you know, kind of ordained them as his apostles. And so he was moving forward in a ministry of love and compassion and concern and casting out demons, and he wasn't doing a thing about the political environment. He wasn't getting rid of the Romans. He wasn't conquering Israel back. He wasn't doing any of the things that the Messiah was supposed to do according to the common teachings in the synagogue, which is why there was so much discussion as to whether he was the Christ or not. You know, and when he asked in Matthew 16, to his apostles, "Who do people say am I? Oh, Elijah, one of the prophets, John the Baptist raised from the dead." People didn't think of him as the Christ because he wasn't doing very Christ-like things according to their tradition and their teaching and what the Messiah was supposed to do. So what happened then, when his family heard about all these things that Jesus is doing, they went to take charge of him. And literally, the tenses in the Greek show that, I mean, this, they weren't kidding around. They were going to grab him and take him by force. And why? For they said, he's out of his mind. They literally thought Jesus had gone insane. Look what he's doing. He's gone insane. Now, in the midst of this is Mary's mother. Remember, Jesus' mother and brothers came to see him. And they're coming to see him because they think about his, out of his mind. Verse 31 of Mark chapter 3, then Jesus' mother and brothers arrived. You see, it says in verse 21, they left to take charge of him. Then by verse 31, when Jesus' mother and brother arrived, standing outside, they sent someone in, the crowd was sitting, they said, your mother and brothers are outside, who are my mother and brothers? He looked at those seated around, here are my mother and brothers, whoever does God's will, blah, blah, blah. So the point is that why was Jesus so rude to his mother and his brothers, his family? Because they were going to come and try and take him by force and take him home, and they thought he was out of his mind. Well, it's pretty powerful the way Jesus handled this, but it does show us something very important in the Unitarian versus Trinitarian discussion. When we talk about biblical Unitarian and our belief that the Bible says that Jesus is the Son of God, the created Son of God, and not God himself incarnate. And what is the interesting thing we learn from this record? Well, if you think about it, Mary was the one who gave birth to Jesus. Mary was the one who the angel said, the one to be born from you will be the Son of God, and you will call his name Jesus. And she's coming to take charge of him. Now, really honestly, if Mary had thought that Jesus was claiming to be God, or Mary had thought that Jesus was God, really, would she be in some kind of plot to take charge of him? No, not at all. You know, for a whole bunch of different reasons. One, nobody's going to be able to take charge of God, period. God's God. He's going to rule. He's always going to win. But even in the culture, the way people thought about God, people were used to, if you will, just kind of like they are today. We have the saying, God works in mysterious ways. People in that biblical culture were used to not really understanding what God was doing. And this goes way, way back. You remember Job? He got sick. He lost his children. He questioned God about his life. Abraham, when God said, you know, about wiping out Sodom and Gomorrah, God questioned him. Will you sweep away the righteous with the wicked? Far be it from you to do such a thing. Will not the judge of all the earth do right? I mean, God, I don't understand you. Elijah, when he's hiding out with a widow woman and her son, and then the son dies. And what's Elijah say? He says, God, have you brought tragedy upon this widow I'm staying with by causing her son to die? God, what is up with you? And I love the one in Jeremiah. Here's Jeremiah chapter 12, verse 1. Jeremiah writes, says, you're always righteous, O Lord, when I bring a case before you. Yet I would speak to you about your justice. Why does the way of the wicked prosper? Why do the faithless live at ease? The prophets all the way back to Abraham and earlier were confused by some of the things that God did. So if Mary thought Jesus was God and he's doing things that don't seem to make sense to her, that's kind of how God is. But Mary knew Jesus wasn't God. She knew Jesus was the Messiah of God. The Messiah was foretold to be a man who would be created by God. You know, so basically, as a man, Mary's thinking, okay, well, here's the Messiah, and he's got this program that he's supposed to do, and he's not doing it. He's forgotten who he is. He's forgotten he's the Messiah. He's forgotten he's supposed to restore Israel. He's forgotten he's supposed to set up his kingdom. He's forgotten these things, and we need to go take charge of him and straighten him out and get him back on the right track. And so that's precisely what they started out to do. Of course, they didn't succeed. But my point is this, that in the discussions between the biblical Unitarian and the Trinitarian position, the fact that Mary would go be part of a group that would want to take charge of her son because she thought he was out of his mind shows that she didn't think he was God at all. And by the way, just for the record, Mary was no pushover spiritually. You know, I've read some commentaries that say, well, you know, Mary really wasn't in on this. She was just kind of going along. That's not what the Bible says. I mean, just read it. It says, his mother and brothers. It's not what the Bible says. And furthermore, like I say, Mary is no pushover spiritually. You know, she took on tremendous spiritual pressure when she said to the Lord, "Be it unto me according to your word." I'm willing to be a pregnant virgin, willing to take the scorn of the world. She was no spiritual pushover. And if she thought that these relatives were crazy, you know, by saying, "Oh, he's out of his mind, let's go get him," she'd say, "You go get him. You know, he's doing what he's supposed to do." So Mary's no pushover, but she got convinced that Jesus was out of his mind. Why? Because she knew Jesus was the Messiah, the Son of God, and that he had things that, according to her theology, and according to the theology that was being taught in the synagogues, he had to do. And he wasn't getting those things done. So that's how Mary became confused and convinced that Jesus was out of his mind. We know, thankfully, from the record, that things got turned around in Mary's life. And of course, there she was at the foot of the cross, and also in Acts chapter 1. What a wonderful believer Mary was. God bless you.